So just kind of tell me what you guys are thinking as we go. So the first thing, this is the foyer. What do you guys think you'd do here?
I think it's empty space, especially with the specs of the home and the size of the home. I'm talking, we're working with a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, 1,700 square feet,
yep.
1726.
Okay, the house actually looks bigger than a 1,700 square foot house, which yeah. is good. It looks yeah. like a pretty grand house. Rehab budget.
125, 130.
So I like how the house flows. You walk in, right? It feels pretty open.
Yeah, it's not bad. It's open, high ceilings. It has a lot of potential. I personally always focus on the kitchen, right? But the kitchen to me, it's just boxed in.
So this is a tiny, tiny, tiny kitchen.
Yeah, very tiny.
One of the main reasons why I want to expand and open the kitchen up is because I cannot stand that the sink is not center with the window.
Oh, is that driving
my OCD doesn't allow that.
Oh, it's just jammed in the corner. It was an afterthought.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so this kitchen is just way too small for the house. I'm trying to figure out, right? So you remove this wall. You know, you could remove this wall, expand the kitchen this way, and make a single door entry. So this will be all open space, and then we'd have lower cabinets running here, so you'd have countertop here,
I like
countertop
that.
Here.
Yeah.
Because I think we can shift that over. And this just a closet?
Yep, that's just a closet.
Okay, so we have some bedrooms back here. All right, just a standard bedroom.
Yeah.
So this is our 1 of 2 bathrooms.
Yes.
What do you think it's gonna cost you to redo this bathroom?
Between 10 to maybe 15,000.
I think about 10. Okay, so just full gut. We need to keep at least 1 bathtub in the house.
Yeah.
I'm sure you guys know yes. that whenever you're flipping houses, keep 1 bathtub for kids and stuff like that. But yeah, the good sized bathroom.
Yeah.
So this is the primary.
This is the primary.
That's a big bedroom.
Yeah, yeah, it's an ample size. And since it's a primary, it'd be nice to have a primary bathroom.
It has no private bathroom?
It has no private bathroom.
And how much are we trying to sell this house for?
1.3.
Okay. We're gonna have to figure that out too then. We might be able to pop in a bathroom right here,
mm-hmm.
but then look how small the main bedroom is.
Yeah.
This is a tricky house, and if they wanna hit the 1.3 million target price, they need to make a lot of layout changes, and that's gonna cost them a lot more than they think. This is real nice. So we have a full bathroom up here. This is a funky floor plan, dude.
It's a very funky floor plan.
Yeah, well, I was thinking maybe we could get rid of this bathroom, push this wall out from the kitchen, extend it 3 to 4 feet, add more space to the kitchen, and relocate this bathroom, hopefully in the main bedroom.
Ah, that would be actually really, really good. The one thing that kind of sucks about this area is you have a bathroom and laundry in the same space.
Yeah,
correct.
Like, to be honest here, this house is even confusing for me. I do believe you guys really need to bring an architect and engineer on this one and really maximize the value.
Okay.
Yeah.
They'll come in here, they'll look at the layouts, and they'll propose you different options.
Okay.
Where it's gonna get costly is reconfiguring the actual floor plan.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a funky house, but if we do it right, I think someone can fall in love.
Yeah. That's what we want.
Oh, you guys have a huge yard.
Yeah.
All right, that's a huge win for Long Beach, you guys.
It is, and that's one of the major reasons why we decided to invest in this property.
Got it. What's up? Do we finally have plans?
We got them, dude.
Hey, look at everything's
finally.
Open.
Yeah.
Everything's
How you
open.
Doing? You good?
I'm good.
So,
hey, the house looks different.
Yeah, dude, a lot of demo. We got a lot open. The vision that we had when we first came in was good, but now it's like great.
Is hiring an architect something you guys do often?
Not
this
all
the
time. This is the first time, actually.
So, I mean, how much value do you think it brought?
Oh, a lot.
Huge.
Because it restructured the whole house.
Why don't we go over this real quick?
So this kitchen is no longer going to be here. Now we've moved the kitchen completely to this side.
So you're taking the entire... Okay, I thought we were going that way. I didn't know we were going this way. Hey,
no.
You know what, though? If you get rid of those windows, you do wall-to-wall cabinets.
Yep. Big island.
Big island, kitchen, the whole nine.
You walk in the front door, then you have a beautiful view of the house.
Yeah. Now there's a kicker though, and this is where we're gonna need your help. So we actually found out that this is not a low bearing wall, okay? So we can actually demo this whole ceiling and go all the way to the ceiling.
So the question is, should you raise this ceiling to match the living room?
Yes.
Is this wall being removed right here?
No, so this wall here is gonna be a pony wall. Dining area here versus the kitchen. And if we do decide to demo the ceiling, obviously it's a grand kind of like, you know, big opening to everything.
I like that. So we just need to figure out what the cost is to open the ceilings.
Okay, and we'll get on that right away.
The architect did a good job.
He did.
That actually makes much better sense because this is like the world's smallest kitchen.
It is.
Yeah.
Okay. And what exactly are you doing to the primary?
We're opening everything up and actually shifting the main bedroom and adding a full main bathroom. So, okay.
Well, the primary is on the other side.
No, this is gonna be the primary.
But so we're question gonna, though.
Yeah.
Because the other bedroom's way bigger.
Yeah, so this is the primary room. We're absorbing the bedroom, secondary bedroom, with the bathroom and closet over here. And then we still have three full bath.
Yep.
Okay. And then you're taking this bedroom and you're creating a little bit of a smaller bedroom.
Yes, now I want to say smaller because we're adding 3 feet. So since we've added 3 feet right away from the entrance, so now we've kind of almost kept it about the same parameters, kind of yeah, same square footage.
Okay. I love everything you guys are doing. It's honestly, it's perfect. But my question is, how much is it going to cost?
We yet to see the final numbers. Once we get those back, we're going to be able to see.
Got it. And one last very important thing. You guys are pulling permits.
Yes, right? We are. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Good. Yeah. Good. Thank you. All right. I'll see you guys all next right time.
Thank you, dude.
Awesome. Good job. Thanks, hey, brother. Love the new plan, and I'm glad you guys got an architect. Are you boys ready for the undercover open house?
Oh, yeah.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
How you guys feeling?
Nervous?
Yeah, we put a lot of time and effort into this, so we gotta...
Yeah. Well, we spent, I think, 3 years.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, well, let's kick this thing off. That looks like a real estate agent and a buyer.
1.6. Uh-huh. We're 10 blocks from the beach.
I like the color scheme for sure.
Yeah.
Landscaping's gonna be easy to maintain.
I like the planner.
Awesome.
Everything flows.
Large center island. That is crazy large. Tons of storage.
With adding the big kitchen, that right there was a risk in itself as well, but I'm so glad we definitely did that.
Yeah. That was your advice. You said hire the architect.
And see? Dude, every now and then.
Big open area for the kitchen.
The backsplash, solid.
Oh yeah.
I like the different textures that it has.
I like the ceilings too as well, how they open up.
If they would have seen it before, huh?
What is
for
this?
Sure. Restroom. I like the sink.
I love the shower.
Yeah, well done.
I like the tile.
It's a laundry room.
Oh,
this brilliant is where the washer and dryer.
This is so smart.
Honestly, I would prefer to have laundry in my bathroom than in the garage.
100%.
Yeah. It has a good flow to it, you know? Everyone around here, so I like the setup for sure.
They match the backsplash with the fireplace.
Yeah, it looks great.
The house is great. And then also you have that view out the back sliders to the huge backyard.
Oh, wow, it's pretty spacious.
Yeah, I did a good job.
It's more backyard than I thought.
There you go.
Yep. AC being right here is not ideal.
Yeah, why did you guys do the AC right outside those sliders?
That's the only place it can go.
There's nothing we can do with the open ceiling the way we have it. It's just, there's no
so
way.
So that was it?
Yeah.
That was it. All right, well, it is what it is.
Let's head on upstairs.
They're heading up to that loft.
The low ceilings make it feel like it's hotter in here.
Yeah, it does feel a little condensed in here.
But there is AC.
Yeah.
Come on, look at
the. And there's a ceiling fan in there, right there too. Just turn the
ceiling
fan on.
Yeah. Exactly.
So there's probably two bedrooms over here. And I'm guessing two more bathrooms.
All right, they're heading to the hall bath.
Look at those tiles. Oh, love the tile. Gorgeous, yeah, absolutely gorgeous.
This looks like all brand new too.
How do you like the flooring?
It's interesting, I like it.
Yeah.
Yeah, they like the blue.
It's good. Like, I was a little concerned that it'd be like too much color. Yeah. We don't have any color in the house.
They like it.
Yeah, it definitely made it pop, and it seems like you're getting great feedback. It's a good call, dude.
Bedroom. Decent size.
Man, if they saw it before, like, you guys literally reframed the entire back of the house.
So this must be the main bedroom?
Primary. That window, though, towards the street. Privacy is not good.
Hey, just add some shutters and you're good.
Lots of closet, lots of lighting.
Closet. Yay, who doesn't love that?
Yeah.
Yes.
Good space.
Double sinks, his and hers.
Oh, look at the walk-in shower.
Oh, wow. Okay, this works.
I mean, okay, honestly, like if you guys didn't redo that floor plan, I don't care how nice the house was, what the design looked like, there's no way it would have sold at this price.
No, I totally agree.
Miguel and Drew took longer than I've ever seen a flip take, but in the end, they transformed the house. The market started to drop and so did their offers, but they're finally in escrow at $1,520,000, which means they'll be splitting a net profit of $187,000.